Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today is going to be the review of the latest build of Bootlegger's ROM based on Android 8.1.0 Oreo for the Redmi Note 3. So without any further ado, let's get started. So here is my Xiaomi Redmi Note 3 running the latest build of Bootlegger's ROM. And by the way guys, I am recording this video on 38 June 2018 and the build date is 22nd June 2018. So this was the latest build at least at the time of recording this video. This ROM remains pretty much similar to the older builds, but yeah, there are some slight changes. So here is the launcher. This is the Pixel launcher, which is customizable from here. As you can see, there are a lot of options that you can use. It is pretty much similar to various other Oreo ROMs guys, pretty much similar I should say. But yeah, there are a couple of extra things here. So here are a couple of pre-install applications that came with this ROM, except PUBG, Antutu Benchmark and ShareIt. All those apps came pre-installed with this ROM. This ROM comes with pretty much all the applications that you need. It doesn't skip in any applications. So let me show you the camera app really quick. And as you can see, again the stock camera app which has been modified. So this camera app has been reviewed by me in .os as well as AEX ROM. So I'll not be going in depth regarding the camera app in this video. By the way, the camera app is working absolutely fine, no issues with that. Let me show you the shutter speed really quick. As you can see, it's blazingly fast. And one good thing about this camera app is that I didn't get any forced closures from past 2 days. Yes, I have been using this ROM from past 2 days, but I was really busy. Sorry for the late upload. As you can see, the video recording is set to 1080p by default. You can go all the way up to 4K if you want, which is working absolutely fine. No lags, no stutters, nothing. It's working really great. But for 4K, the stabilization option doesn't work. It works till 1080p, as you can see. Enabling this option will reduce a little bit shake in the video. So talking about the FM radio is there, but you need to connect an headphone in order to use it. That's good because the quality will be great. Here is the retro music player, as you can see. But beware guys, the retro music player will give a forced close in the beginning. Yes, it was giving me forced close, and even if it doesn't give a forced close, then it will just not detect the media on your device. After a while, after a couple of reboots, it is working fine now. But I am not sure whether it will continue to work the same or not. So that was regarding the retro music player. But nevertheless, you can always use Google Play Music or any other music player that you want. I have flashed the JApps Micro and it is working absolutely fine here, no issues with that. So here is the settings menu, the about device section, and as you can see, this is the Bootlegger's ROM. Tapping on this doesn't do anything, and the maintainer name is Dino. The security patch is of June 5, 2018. Here is a pretty different kernel. As you can see, it says Candy, Dino at Death Valley. So it has its own kernel. That's a really nice thing. Bootlegger version, here it says 22.6.2018, which I told you earlier. The Cell Linux status is permissive. Talking about the security and lock screen, fingerprint scanner is working absolutely fine. And I have also got the Face ID and voice match working absolutely fine on this ROM, as you can see. Let me show you the speed of fingerprint scanner really quick. As you can see, it's definitely faster than some other Oreo ROMs, that's for sure. It might be because of faster animations, I'm not sure about it, but it's a little bit faster. Going into the display option, here are a couple of things that comes in the display option. Let us try the nightlight feature really quick. And it is working absolutely fine, no issues with that as you can see. So let me show you some other things like the UI style, which is on wallpaper based by default. You can put it to some other things if you want. Like if you put it on dark, then the system UI will become darker, or you can say black. But there is a specific option for black too, you can use that. You can also change the accent color, which is nothing but this color. Let me show you that. And here it is. Let me show you some of the other things that comes in the display panel. As you can see, the ambient display is there, which is set for new notifications. Double tap to wake is also there, let us try that. By the way, the double tap to sleep on status bar is there. And here it is, the double tap to wake works absolutely fine, no issues with that. So here are a couple of customization options. As you can see, it is pretty much similar to various other Oreo ROMs guys. I'll be showing you only the important ones in this video. If you want more details, then the links will be in the description. You can watch pretty much any video there. I have reviewed the customization options in depth in the Nitrogen OS. You can watch that review if you want. So going into the status bar, you can control pretty much everything on the status bar, like the 4G icon on status bar, roaming indicator, you can disable those. You can also enable network traffic monitor, which is disabled by default. It will show your current upload and download speed, both for Wi-Fi and the mobile data. So you can change the alignment of clock, you can enable AM or PM, you can enable date, you can change the date format, you can change the battery style from here. So currently it's on portrait, you can put it to dotted circle, circle and pretty much everything. You can show the battery percentage next to the icon or inside the icon. So from here you can customize your hardware keys, you can remap them, You can enable on-screen navigation buttons from here, which are working absolutely fine, no issues with that. So you can also control the animations from here, as you can see. So let us try the QI style animation. And here it is. So this doesn't come enabled by default, you need to enable that. It's pretty cool by the way, it looks really awesome. I'll not be disabling that. And there are a couple of other animations too. You can also disable animations. Android P animations were also there, let me show you. As you can see. So now all the animations, at least some animations, will be displayed like Android P ones. Here it is. Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, etc. works absolutely fine, no issues with them. And the mobile data is also working, no issues with that. Let me show you my last AnTuTu score really quick. And here it is, I have got a score of 96,893. And one of my subscribers asked me to show the details of the AnTuTu score. Here you go friend, you can pause the screen and have a look at it. Here it is. By the way, the 96,893 score is pretty good, I should say. It is a little bit better than some other ROMs too. But yeah, it is not as good as the AEX ROM and I think the Havok OS, which were able to score a little bit more than a lakh. The link should be in the description. Performance is really good, day-to-day usage is really great, there are no lags whatsoever. I haven't modified anything in this ROM, I haven't enabled Vulkan, as I showed you the about device section, you might have got an idea regarding that. It's on stock kernel and everything is stock what it comes with. So talking about the battery life, let me show you my battery states really quick. So the downward curve is the PUBG gameplay guys. It was not draining the battery, we cannot call it as a battery drain, but yeah, the battery life was getting kernel reduced while playing PUBG. And PUBG was not that smooth guys, it was not as smooth as Havok OS, but it was playable for most of the part, but somewhere here and there it was giving stutters and the device was heating up like crazy. This one is the standby, it just drained 1% of battery on standby for 12 hours I think. I was really surprised to see that. Here is the proof, and this small downwards curve you are looking at is the review what I am making now. The battery is down to 73%. Most of the battery was drained during PUBG gameplay. So coming into the power management, here are a couple of other things like the smart pixels. When you enable this, then it will disable some of the pixels on your display to save some battery. Here it is, but it doesn't look great at all. If you want more details, then I'll have the XDA forum link in the description. You can visit that link, you can visit the forum and get pretty much any details you want. So this was a quick little review of the Bootleggers ROM let us build on the Redmi Note 3. So that's pretty much it for this video guys, if you liked it, give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. This is all about technology 24/7, signing off for the moment, you guys have a great day, peace.